Welcome back to our MedSmarter lecture series, where we're taking a smarter approach to preparing future physicians. Before we get started, if you'll take just a quick minute and click that like button, and also subscribe and turn the bell on so that you'll be notified when we post new videos. So let's talk a little bit about the lymph and the lymph drainage and some of those associated pathologies with that particular lymph system. So we're going to break these up into clusters of lymph nodes, what it drains, and then how it's associated with a pathology. So our first lymph node cluster is going to be the cervical or the supraclavicular lymph nodes. These are in the head and neck area of the body, and it's associated with any pathologies associated with upper respiratory tract infections, infectious mono, and Kawasaki's disease. So if you have any viral infections of the upper portions of the body, upper respiratory tract, head, neck, then you can have lymphadenopathy when you have one of these diseases. The next lymph node cluster is the mediastinal lymph node. This is around the trachea and the esophagus, and it is paired together with the hilar lymph nodes, which are near the lungs in the middle of the body, mostly because of the pathologies that it's associated with. The mediastinal and the hilar lymph nodes will be associated with these same diseases and pathologies. So pulmonary TB is associated with both the mediastinal and the hilar lymph nodes and hilar lymphadenopathy. Sarcoidosis, primary lung cancer, and granulomatous disease. All four of those will be drained by the mediastinal and the hilar lymph nodes. So if you do have any issues associated with that, we need to biopsy the lymph nodes. Those are the two lymph node systems that we will go to see if there's any lymph drainage and effects with that particular lymph node system. And then we have the axillary lymph node system. This drains the upper limb, the breast, and the skin above the umbilicus. It's most commonly associated with mastitis and then metastasis. So the most common thing that we'll see with this is an association with breast cancer. So patients that are diagnosed with breast cancer, we always look to the lymph nodes to see if there's any metastasis, if it's moved anywhere else besides in that breast tissue. It can move in other directions, but typically the first place it goes is to where its lymph drainage is. So we will check the axillary lymph nodes to see if there is any presence of those cancer cells. If so, then we can determine how much further it could have spread through the body via the lymph system. The next lymph node cluster we'll talk about is the celiac cluster, and then we'll also discuss superior and inferior mesenteric. They are all grouped together here because their pathologies are the same. The celiac, though, however, only drains the liver, stomach, spleen, pancreas, and upper part of the duodenum. It does not touch any of the other systems in the abdomen that the superior and inferior mesenteric lymph nodes will, even though it's associated with the same pathologies. Your superior mesenteric is the lower duodenum, the jejunum, the ileum, and then the colon only up to the splenic flexure. So in that left upper quadrant where we have the transverse colon become the descending colon, that is where the superior mesenteric lymph nodes cut off. And below that is where we have our inferior mesenteric. They come from the splenic flexure to the upper part of the rectum. So how are these all associated with the same pathologies? Well, mesenteric lymphadenitis, typhoid fever, ulcerative colitis, and celiac disease can all be associated with many of these different lymph node systems. So you can have inflammation in any of these associated with any of those particular pathologies. The para-aortic lymph node system drains the testes, ovaries, kidneys, and uterus. Most commonly associated with metastasis here. You may look at this and go, hold on one second. The ovaries are in the lower part of the abdomen. The testes are in the scrotum, even further south from that point. Pretty far away from the kidneys, uterus, you know, down in the ovaries area. But testes specifically. Remember, the testes specifically develop well up into the abdomen and then they descend. So their venous and their arterial blood supply and their origination and lymph drainage will all come from higher up in the body than where they currently reside. Wrapping up our lymph node clusters, we cluster these three particular clusters together, the external iliac, the internal iliac, and the superficial inguinal, because of their associated pathologies as well. So our external iliac is associated with the cervix, the superior bladder, and the body of the uterus. The internal iliac is our lower rectum. So remember we mentioned previously the inferior mesenteric goes to the upper part of the rectum. From that point, the internal iliac takes over on the lower part of the rectum to the anal canal. And it's specifically the anal canal above the pectinate line. If you remember back into our GI discussions, the pectinate line is that white line that separates the internal anus from the external anal canal. The bladder, vagina, middle third of that, cervix, and the prostate are all drained by the internal iliac. And then the superficial inguinal is going to be the anal canal below the pectate line, so almost to the exterior of the body, the skin below the umbilicus, except for the popliteal area, the scrotum, and the vulva. So the testes reside in the scrotum, but they're not drained by the same inguinal lymph nodes as the testes are. So the testes, remember, come from further up in the body, from the para-aortic, and then the scrotum comes from the superficial inguinal. The popliteal lymph node cluster, the final lymph node cluster we'll talk about, is located near the knee, and it is the dorsolateral foot and posterior calf that are drained by the popliteal lymph nodes, and its associated pathologies here are going to be lateral foot and leg cellulitis. If you found this material helpful for your studying, please like and consider subscribing to the channel. Also, share this video so that more people can benefit from it like you have.